Chief of the Naval Staff, Admiral Karambir Singh, Chief of the Army Staff, General Manoj Naravane, former Chiefs, AOCNC Western Air Command, Air Marshal Amit Dev, senior officers from the three services and the Ministry of Defence, defence attachés of friendly foreign countries, distinguished guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, on the 89th anniversary of the Indian Air Force, I extend my best wishes and welcome you all to this event. First and foremost, I place on record my appreciation for the parade commander and all air warriors on parade for an exceptional display of discipline and josh. Your precise drill movements and immaculate turnout are indicative of high levels of morale, pride in your uniform, and esprit de corps, all of which form the bedrock of the air warriors' credo. I would also like to congratulate all the award winners for their exemplary achievements. Good show and well done. My compliments to the Air Officer Commanding in Chief, Western Air Command, and Air Officer Commanding Hindon for putting up such a befitting show despite ongoing operational commitments and challenges posed due to the COVID pandemic. As the Indian Air Force enters its 90th year, the men and women in blue who serve the nation today are proud custodians of a legacy of valor, sacrifice, and pioneering spirit. It is a great honor for me to stand before you as the successor to a great lineage of commanders who charted a course for the service and brought us to where we stand today. Their achievements have not come without cost. In particular, I salute the former chiefs for their visionary leadership. As our challenges continue to rise, so does our strength and resolve to ensure the best possible application of air power. When I look at the security scenario that we face today, I am acutely conscious that I have assumed command at a crucial time. We must demonstrate to the nation that external forces will not be allowed to violate our territory. I pledge to do all I can to provide you with clear directions, good leadership, and the best of resources that I can muster. On behalf of all air warriors, I also pay homage to our fallen braves who have made the supreme sacrifice in the line of duty. Today is an occasion to renew our solemn pledge for preserving the Indian Air Force's rich heritage and passing it on to future generations. Dear air warriors, the year gone by has been quite challenging, yet extremely rewarding. The prompt actions in response to developments in Eastern Ladakh was a testament of the Indian Air Force's combat readiness. Our efforts in completing all COVID-related tasks was also a major achievement in support of the national effort. Your accomplishments have been impressive, and you have helped achieve significant progress in many areas. I want to thank each of you and your families for the sacrifices that you have made and continue to make while serving in this glorious service. I will continue to rely on your skills, courage, determination, and hard work in the years ahead. Remember that it is our sacred duty to protect the nation's sovereignty and integrity at any cost, and you are to do what it takes to ensure that we do not let the nation down. The security environment in our region and beyond has been impacted by a complex interplay of geopolitical forces. Moreover, the advent of new domains over and above the traditional domains of land, sea, and air have resulted in a paradigm shift in the way military operations will be conducted. In sync with the changing nature of war fighting, ongoing capability enhancement in the Indian Air Force is aimed at providing the optimum means for employing air power and achieving desired effects across domains swiftly and decisively. The theme for this year's anniversary celebrations, Atmanirbhar Evam Saksham, is most apt, since with the ongoing acquisition of a high percentage of Made in India platforms, weapons, and combat systems, The Indian Air Force stands today on the threshold of an era which will define its stature as a potent strategic aerospace power. The Indian Air Force has been at the vanguard of indigenization in domestic aerospace sector, and due to concerted efforts at all levels, a large number of low-tech, low-cost and high-volume spares have been indigenized across all fleets. The need of the hour is to reassess and realign with emerging trends in order to gain from ongoing efforts towards greater self-reliance in high-tech items. I am happy to report that several projects are well underway for harnessing the potential of automation, data analytics, and artificial intelligence in order to transform the way we fight future wars. The young men and women who are joining the Indian Air Force are highly competent and naturally adept in today's digital world. We have to upgrade our operational training methodology so that these air warriors are equipped with the right skills and knowledge for confident and audacious use in battle. In fact, I am of the view that while we are actively pursuing self-reliance in hardware, innovative thought has historically been our core strength, and I look forward to skillful and creative employment of these capabilities through development of our own unique tactics and out-of-the-box operational plans. While targeted training programs are helping our personnel to develop the aptitude for mastering modern trends of aerial warfare, acquiring the right attitude is equally important. Our focus on grooming and mentoring them as leaders for shouldering the onerous tasks should be sustained. It is my firm belief that while we continue to acquire latest technology, there is a much greater need to devote our attention to the people placed below us. As the seniors, invest your time and effort in nurturing and empowering your subordinates. I am confident that each one of you will treat this important task as your primary responsibility. The Indian Air Force remains steadfast in its view that integrated jointness is the way ahead. It is also our belief that the core competence of each service, indeed of all organs of national power, must be synergized to generate the desired effect and capability. Here I wish to assure the nation of our unwavering commitment towards delivering joint capability and generating integrated response options as a part of a coherent national strategy. In the end, I say this to all air warriors: do your best every day, and I promise to do the same. We must look into the future with clear eyes, confronting the challenges before us and not forgetting the sacrifices made by our predecessors in service of the nation. I urge each one of you to continue to serve with pride and always remain true to the hallowed values that the Indian Air Force